everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ekta and today's video is a little different because in this video I'm going to show you how you can get quickly ready for the Navratri, Garba, Ras Dandiya or whatsoever function that's going in your society without spending a lot of time, a lot of money on expensive makeup. Yes, in this video I'm going to use and try all the different lesser known but budget friendly makeup that I have bought recently from Amazon. Let's see if they work for me or not. I am going to directly apply this primer on my face. This is from Lakme and I have done the review of the same. Apply it all over my face. Oh my god, is it a little much? Let's see. So the primer is done. Do not forget to apply the primer and the moisturizer equally on your face and on the visible part of your neck area. You can also do it on your hands also. Never mind, we'll just add some smoothing kind of effect. I understand, you know, when you're going for Navratri, especially Garba, it tends to get sweaty and all. So, you know, if you want to have a makeup that stays for more, you should try watching this video of mine, which I have done a couple of years back, which will give you really good tips about how to do your traditional Garba makeup and keep it for long time. In today's video, also, this makeup will also last you longer. Do not forget to put an eye on your face before applying makeup. Nevertheless, my primer is done. I'm going to color correct the dark circles. As you can see, I have a lot of dark circles around my eye area, so I'm gonna using this orange color corrector from Thailand. It is around 250 or 300 rupees that I have bought. Oh, before I do color correction on my eyes, I'm going to try this eyeshadow primer from this brand called Insight Cosmetics. Love the nice pink kind of a color. This is the first time I'm using this product. Consistency is nice. So what I will do is I'll apply it all over my eyelids, around the eye area also, and blend it with my finger. The formulation is very nice, little thick yet very creamy. I kind of, you know, like the first application. And now I'm gonna take this color corrector and do some color correction and come back. Not get overwhelmed by a lot of orange on my face. This is a very important process if you have dark circles, but if you are someone who is not blessed with dark circles and you're really blessed, you can skip this process. So I'll just quickly blend it. Because of the eye primer, you know, the application of the color corrector have become very easier. Do not get overwhelmed by this orange corrector over here. I will you know, kind of conceal it with the foundation right now. For the foundation, I'm going to try the shade from Insight Cosmetics. I have actually bought the sun base and applied in that other video, but I thought this was a little lighter shade, so this time I have called for another shade which is like warm nude. So I'm gonna try this shade and see which one is a close match. I think this one would be a closer match for my skin tone. Why this drop foundation kind of things, you know, they don't have a lot of product. Like I have tried one from Sugar and had really less product. This one also seems to have, you know, very limited kind of product. Now I'll take this beauty blender and blend it all. Is this shade good enough for my skin tone and the coverage? The coverage seems to be, you know, not so high. Let me apply this quickly and come back. So I applied almost 2 coats of this foundation. I'm not sure about the camera. It looks decent, but in reality it has a very natural kind of a coverage and this is looking quite nice. I think, you know, it will take some time to settle down because last time when I applied the other one, it was very bright in the beginning, but once it settled down on my skin, it looked quite a good match over the screen at least. So I'm gonna allow it to settle down. I have applied a little bit on the eye area also. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the other shade and use it as a concealer. So there's a new trend which says concealer aise lagao. So basically concealer is to hide your dark circles. again, you know, the product is very less inside these bottles. I don't know what is the problem. Let me check it out, you know, better after the tutorial. I have randomly applied it all over my face. Never mind. Sponge, blender, and blend it thoroughly. So I'm done with the foundation number 2. I tried to use a foundation to do the concealing, but I think so far it is like kind of okay, nothing very great. But like I said, my first experience using the same foundation was quite good. The sunscreen, the face looked quite nice. So I'm hoping it settles down and gives a better coverage by then. I'm going to settle this all with a compact powder. For this, I'm taking this one from My Glam. I will take some powder and dust it with very light hand. Hold the brush below the ferrule. This is the ferrule, and in the meantime, I'm gonna do some contouring. And for that, I'm gonna try this duo, 2-in-1 stick by Insight Cosmetic. And this has contour cream at one side and a highlighter at the other side. I normally don't do nose contouring. I think this would be quite handy. I have a very sharp nose, they say, so I don't do nose contouring as such. I'll apply a little bit here to give it a slightly cut effect. Okay, it again has a very nice, subtle kind of finish. I'm gonna blend it all. For my eye makeup, I'm going to try this Beauty Glaze palette. And this has a lot of eyeshadows you can play with. Look at these, yeah. I'll take this light kind of a brown over here. Apply it all over my eyelids. I think it's getting a little dark over here, so let me fix the light and come back. I haven't wet my brush, but the pigment is decent. I'm just placing it all over my eyelid. Yeah, so I changed the light a little bit. My face might be looking a little ashy at this point. Do not worry, I'm going to fix it because a lot of extra compact on my face. So let's continue with the eyeshadow. So I'm picking this shade and placing it here on the eyelid. I'm gonna use a very subtle kind of an eye makeup over here so that everyone can do it. Yeah. Now I'm going to take a darker shade, something like this maroon kind of a shade, and place it from the end of my eyebrows towards the middle. Yeah. Since it's a night event, I'm going to add a little bit of sparkle over here. You can ignore if you do not have, or if you have nothing like it, just take this onion pink kind of a glitter over here. A very little bit I'll pick on my existing brush and place it here from the inner corners. Yeah, just a little bit from the inner corner towards the middle corner, and with the help of a clean brush, gonna blend it all. I'm going to take the same maroonish kind of a color for the lower eyeline. Yeah. With the help of a spoolie brush, I'm going to define my brow. So for the brow, what I'll do is I'll take this black color from the same palette and use this to fill my brows. I'll use a very nice thin pencil brush, and highlight the brow bones. I'm gonna use the same highlighter, the duo stick, and apply it on the brow bone. I'll place it on the cheekbones also. For the inner corner of my eyes, I'll take this shade and just since we do not have a blush, so again I'm going to multitask. I'm going to use the same eyeshadow palette and pick up a color. Maybe I'll pick something very light, very peachish, because I have a little darker kind of a, you know, red kind of an eye makeup. I'll pick up this light peachy pink kind of a product, little bit, place it on my cheeks. For the lipstick, I'm going to take a shade from this Just Herbs Small Lip Ampoules. So I'm going for something a little subtle and neutral, a little towards the, you know, brown to pink side. I've picked up the shade number 9. Looking a little too pinkish, so I'll go for something a little brownish. I'm gonna try the shade number 13. It is gonna set up my makeup using this makeup fixer from Blue Heaven. Just a bit of it, little bit. To outline my eyes, I'm going to use this liquid eyeliner. You can either go for a gel eyeliner or liquid eyeliner. Avoid kajal if possible, because kajal, you know, can melt because of heat and make it look little, you know, burnt up kind of a thing. So I'm gonna use this one from My Glam.